it is.
It's funny, right? Because he is obviously playing a super economic game, but at the same time, he's stacking up to the highest tier unit in the game. We do still a little bit of that ranged lip that you mentioned, though, and especially in the later phase of the game, it could be incredibly powerful. That's kind of how Hero Marine was able to steal that one victory. A Baneling Nest already being thrown down for Cero.
Yeah, I mean, this could mean a couple things, defensive and offensive. Couple utilities options there for that Baneling tech. Hellions get spotted here, and Special's Natural looks rather vulnerable, actually, apart from the Hellions. You could actually, if you were Serral and you wanted to get aggressive, probably do a lot of damage. We're seeing nothing but drones here from Serral. There's the BC in the main base, and Serral does not look ready for this. He's bringing in those Queens to defend against the BC. Pulls the drones back. Oh, he's reading them like a book here, bringing in those extra Queens down on the edge of that creep, pushing him back off the precipice of it here. One Queen goes down. That's a nice pick off so far for the BC. Another drone. Two drones in total.
This is already a much more successful opening with this BC than the Tymed on King's Cove. He got the Queen, and it's really nice, right? Because every Queen you pick off, that means that Queen is not regenerating energy, and that means a couple of less transfusions down the road, and of course less creep tumors as well. And that is also important to keep in check when you play against Serral. And Special did not decide to do anything super crazy with his Hellions. He's like, you know what, if you're dealing with my BC with only two or three Queens, then I'll just make sure that I'll keep my Hellions at home because I know you have plenty of Hellions to defend my, or excuse me, plenty of Queens to defend my Hellions.
The BC's here just trying to chase down an Overseer. They unfortunately can't catch it. And Serral gonna get some information. Again, like he is very, very good and like clockwork with his scouting. So he's going into the main to see what Special is doing to confirm the follow-up. He knows now 100% without a shadow of doubt that he is up against a lot of mech units, that there is a fourth base, and he needs to come up with a game plan. At the moment, he is making roaches because he has so many Hellions to deal with. And as far as the ground army goes for Serral, it's kind of thin.
But I do like the Ravagers, though. Like, I know the roaches may seem a little bit silly, but roaches are obviously going to be useful against all the other units. But don't underestimate the power of Corrosive Bow on these massive air units. Maynard, I'm not afraid to admit it, I've lost plenty of carriers against Corrosive Bow. Because once those units are neuroparasited, of course, you can't control them, and that will allow Serral to land a whole bunch of those Corrosive Bows on those air units.
Seeing Burrow being researched here from Serral, could potentially help out Roaches and also help out drones if they're being harassed. And he wanted to go for a Ling Run by, but Special actually caught it with his Hellions and pushed him back. Special on creep here, the Banelings looking for nice connections. He kites back, stuck on the edge there a little bit. Ah, yeah, there's the neural grab. This is what we're talking about. Those BCs aren't going anywhere. They've used their tactical jumps.
Oh, that's smart.
And they cannot go home.
But he does get one Yamato up on one of these Queens. Actually, no, Yamato the other BC. That's pretty sick as well. At the same time, a couple of Zerglings pick up the tanks. One Battlecruiser did survive that little skirmish, so you can say that's something. But obviously, it can jump away, and it can Yamato right now. Really nice catch by Serral.
And Serral's starting to amass a bit of a bank here as he approaches Max with the Hive on the way as well. He's been all about the attack upgrades because that really does help you out against mech. And it's going to be needing Vipers very shortly, so that's what the Hive is for. Hellion's going for a run by. They do have Blue Flame attack here, but they don't have any attack upgrades, so they're not actually that strong.
Yeah, the numbers weren't really there, right, for the Hellions. I must say, already extra star points now for Special as well. Obviously, he's rich. He's going up to 5 bases at this point, so he's going to get a pretty sick economy. The Nidus Network has been planted down as well.
Oh, that bungle from the high ground! Serral, you monster! So sick. Great catch there from the finish, Zerg. Oh my god.
He hasn't made a lot of investors yet, but the few that he did, they've already paid for themselves, Maynard. How do you land a fungal like that? Come on.
Oh man, using that terrain to the best ability here. And Special's just lost a ton of his army, his presence on this side of the map, his ability to pressure back the creep and all that that you want to be doing with Battleneck. It's not here anymore. He doesn't have the unit count. He's just chilling back at home. And it looks like another Neural available on this Infestor as well, but does need to be careful. There is Yamato's here.
Getting Yamato a Ravager, I think. Yes, he does, in the back of that army. First, Nidus goes down near the Zelnaga Watchtower. It's going to spot these BCs, actually, and the BCs are going to see the Nidus as well, so they should be able to take care of it. Two Spires being planted down now for Serral.
Now, Special is actually just massing Battlecruisers right now. That's all he's doing. And with his upgrades going, he's been just getting ship weapon upgrades and vehicle plating. So he's all about Sky Terran at the moment. He does have a ground army, but it's not what he's attending to.
You know, there was a game not too long ago that Serral played on this map against Gumiho. You remember? And at one point, Serral just didn't check the side of Gumiho, the side of the map of Gumiho for a very long time. And he kind of thought he was playing against a mix of mech units. And then suddenly it was nothing but Battlecruisers. And Serral simply lacked the anti-air. The two Spires that he has planted down right now give me the feeling that Serral is like, all right, that happened once. I'm going to make sure that doesn't happen again. Fongo and Corrosive Bar. One Battlecruiser goes down and the other one barely survives.
Tactical jumps out of there, but losing one BC does kind of hurt his comp here, which is basically pure Battlecruiser. He's squeezing in some Cyclones and Hellions because he has to. He needs to do something to this pre-spread and keep Serral not free and clear. Bunch of Locusts coming forward, but that's a lot of Battlecruisers. They don't care about Locusts.
Nope, a couple of the SCVs will go down, though, that were underneath it, but obviously the amount of SCVs that Special had, this is not that big of a deal in this phase in the game, and Serral has plenty of bases. I'd like to see those Roaches from Serral on the south side maybe go behind the mineral lines, because then you can actually still harass the SCVs.
He doesn't have high sec, so you can be quite annoying. I mean, even if you did it, I'm pretty sure you can outrange it.
Bad time to be a barracks man.
I don't know why that's so funny to me, but...
Well, because you don't have to see a barracks flying into seven spore crawlers. I don't blame you for it. Yeah.
It's been a while since the last time I've seen that. Oh, these murals, big fumble as well. Corrosive Bile!
Oh my god.
Serral is ridiculous.
Oh my goodness. I mean, a couple of these BCs do make the short jump as well. Corruptors, is the Corruptor count high enough to take out the other ones? More Corrosive Biles are going to connect with a few of these BCs. I mean, it's amazing that these three are still alive, actually, but Special needs to max out, right? He needs to keep those super expensive units alive, and Serral is getting some juicy trades.
Nice Liberator here in the bottom left of the map is, I guess, the glass full situation, especially is doing damage to the economy of Serral. But Serral is definitely in the advantage right now, getting rid of some tanks. He can afford to lose some drones. It's not the biggest of deals. And like you said, the plan here for Special is to get 3-3 upgrades for his big Battlecruiser fleet, just like Gumiho did when he defeated Serral on this map in I Am Katowice. But it's just been a real hard trek here, a real hard journey for Special to get there.
Yep. He has already lost 6 Battlecruisers in this game, and that's a unit you're just not supposed to lose. You can maybe lose 1 or 2 by accident, or one of these neural stealing one. But 6, while you're only hovering at 160, 170 supply for the majority of it. But hey, Serral's still making links, Serral's still making banelings. I absolutely do not want to make it sound like Special's out of this game. It feels like Serral domination, and I think it kind of has been. But hey, Special still has a lot of Battlecruisers, and he's adding in even more. And with a couple of Yamatos and maybe avoiding those Neuroparasites, there is absolutely some hope here for our Mexican Terran player.
These Cyclones getting caught here. They did do their job, though. They picked off a lot of those Swarm Hosts. Hellion's coming forward to try and deal with that Ling count. Tries for a Fungal, gets the... Oh my god, that's so many Banelings. That Planetary is toast.
It's like, really wanted to get the Refinery as well?
Take that, Refinery! Oh, lots of Yamatos here. Those trades for Special actually quite good.
Yep, I mean, that was expensive. That's exactly what I mean. Serral still didn't really have the Dream anti-air army. Just lost a whole bunch. A few of these Banelings are still alive. Yeah, you can actually, I wouldn't say roll them in, but there were 2 tanks on the left side. So only a few additional SCVs went down there. Hey, Special really fighting back in the last minute of this game.
Yeah.
He's not been bleeding out Battlecruisers anymore. Losing the PF, yeah, that stings a little bit. But that wasn't cheap for Serral either. He used a lot of Banelings to get that done.
I feel like Serral's gaining ground, actually. Like, that was a lot of resources there for Serral. He does have a bank, but it's not incredible. If Serral takes a bad fight to a maxed out Terran, it's hard for him to get a big, scary second wave army.
Yep, and these BCs, I mean, it doesn't really get much better than that, right, for the Terran player. Adding a few Liberators here and there, there are still a couple of defensive tanks remaining, but Serral was the one who was up in supply, and he had a bunch of money in the bank. Suddenly, that's not really the case anymore. It's important, of course, Special lifts up that command center, but he does in the end. A couple of these aliens going down. That's not the biggest of deals. The sensor now getting picked off is nice. I don't think that this is going to be able to morph into a planetary, even though the Hellions are maybe here to save the day.
Yeah, Hellion's doing a nice job here. Even without any attack upgrades, still getting rid of those Lings. Tanks also covering here. Serral running by Lings every which way. He knows that they're not going to be great in a stand-up fight here, especially considering most of the army of Special is in the air. Oh, the Infestors here sharking Roddy. They're getting close. They have the Corruptors with them as well. Serral looking like he wants to pick a fight.
And it's important that the next fight is going good for Serral, though. Like you said, he has spent most of that bank, and yeah, he got some done with it, but this is not an army that our Finnish Zerg can afford to lose. A couple of tanks are very exposed. They're left by themselves. Where are those BCs going, Manny?
I guess they're heading towards Serral's base. They want to start killing hatcheries and killing static defense. This is so risky, though.
Maybe
he does have tactical jumps, so he can always just shoot home after killing a hatchery.
More and more BCs on their way. The Corruptor's about to show up. A couple of Battlecruisers low on HP, by the way, is to be very careful with it. Serral still denying expense on the other side of the map. Year Zero living up to the hype again, Maynard. What a cool game already.
Yeah, and a glorious map and a glorious TBC for game one of the grand final. Yamato's getting quite a few of those Corruptors, and then Special just bounces back home to get rid of what remains of the ground army there for Serral.
Yeah, nothing crucial went down for the attack of Sero. He still has the most of the buildings that he truly needs. But hey, Sero no longer maxed out at the moment. He's getting all the upgrades. Even his links are super strong, right? He's got crazy upgrades on pretty much everything. Still getting those extra air upgrades as well. But Special is like, you know what? As long as I get one more base up and running, I'm just going to babysit my battlecruisers properly. And if I can avoid those neuroparasites and a massive fungo in the crosser balls, they can absolutely take care of those Corruptors.
This is something that I've only ever really seen Serral do at these big tournament matches, is he gets extra lairs up to get more hit points on his command structures, these hatcheries and lairs and hives. Way more hit points, so they can actually deal with a lot more damage from, say, the battlecruisers if there's a stand-up fight. Won't lose those production facilities. And here we go, just a small Roach Ravager army for Serral, being a little bit annoying. Special avoiding the edge of the creep here. Losing the Battlecruiser fleet means GG. There's those fungals, there's those murals. Special is stuck fighting here. A lot of his units aren't actually in the battle. He turns and fights though. 3-3 upgrades on these Battlecruisers. Can he actually cut through these Corruptors? It doesn't look good for Special. He's losing a lot of army supply.
A couple of DFS and Terrans helping out as well from underneath. There was a Sportcrawler helping out, but there are still a couple Battlecruisers remaining. But Special supply has plummeted. He once again lost a lot. Look at the SCVs. No, don't repair the alien. Repair the big boy. He needs it way more.
I think they were on auto repair, Roddy. A mistake for Special. His PCs get out of harm's way, but now Serral has got free reign of this planetary if he wants to caustic spray it.
Yeah, but now Sero is once again investing in a couple of those other units to take care of those buildings. Obviously, a phenomenal fight for Sero. I was kind of worried, I'm not gonna lie. I thought the Infest account maybe wasn't really there. That we do have that ability of the Corruptors and that damage, nobody out repairs that.
Absolutely not. You're just delaying the inevitable at that point. Ling's also trying to run by here. Sero always hitting in several places at once. And Special, once again, just trying to get as many upgraded air units as he can, but he can't really do it anymore. He doesn't have the minerals.
Nope, still has plenty of command centers and orbitals scattered around the map, but you're right. I mean, the BCs are so expensive. It's not a unit where you can simply, it's like, oh, okay, I'm maxed out. I should have a bank for 6 or 7 more. No, you just don't have that. You simply do not have that. And Sero has done a really good job that despite the fact he never feels that rich, he's always close to maxed out. And then whenever he loses a couple of units, he does have the money again to replace those units.
Oh. It just feels like the Terran has to be so passive here and just try and take good trades wherever he can. That's never a comfortable situation. He wants to be out there on the map, picking off hatcheries, doing damage, Hellion run-bys, that sort of thing. There are a lot of vulnerable bases, but Serral is always on top of the army here for Special. Gets a fungal on the Hellions as well. Pushes him way back, forces another command center, which Special desperately needs to be mining here for him. Gotta get that BC fleet up. It's just dead.
Yeah, it's either the Roaches or the Corruptors,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, choose your death.
Yep. There's a couple of links really working on that one orbital that's now burning down as well. Would be awesome if Special could maybe repair it. Special still got an army, guys. I know it doesn't look pretty, and I know it feels like Serral domination, but he still has over 100 army supply. He's got a lot of battlecruisers. The Infest account is at 9. Yes, that's good, but if Special can get a good engagement on those Infestors, there is absolutely hope for Special to take a convincing victory in a big battle, but he needs Serral to mess up.
He might get one Infestor here with a lock on the Cyclone. That's nice. Does get a Fungal there on the Cyclones. That Fungal not as consequential as the earlier ones. Here he comes! This might be the last fight in the game! More Neurals, more Corruptors, more Fungals, and Special has to tap out! Serral!